today I'm going to do this particular hairstyle, which I know you will love, so let's get started. So to start with this hairstyle, you definitely want to part the hair right in the middle, like so. We've already done that before. And a good reminder before you start with any hairstyling is make sure that the hair is brushed. I'm going to use a paddle brush, which works really, really well. Just make sure to get all tangles out of the way. So we're going to begin sectioning the hair. So I'm going to clip it. I'm going to take about 1 inch section and clip the rest up. In order for this hairstyle to look great and last, you definitely want to prep the hair with hairspray. So I'm going to spray a little bit, just prepare the hair right before we're curling iron. Okay, I am going to take this curling iron and just take about, I would say anywhere from a half inch to 1 inch section and hold it taut. So for us to have an even curl, it's best to hold the curling iron up and down. And I'm going to do a wand method. So I'm going to literally curl it around the curling iron. And you hold it down for about 10 seconds. So this is the back section already complete. It looks absolutely beautiful. Nice, beautiful, springy curls. So what I ended up doing was taking the section on both sides in front of the ear and sectioning it off because we're gonna curl this area next. So again, with the curling iron up and down, wrap the hair around just like so. Now that we have completed curling the entire hair, our next section is our rope braid. And I have already taken a weft of hair and did a rope braid using hair ties on each side to hold it. This would be the easiest way to incorporate the rope braid, quote unquote, tiara. You could use a section of hair of your own hair in the back and do the same technique and put it around and pin it. But I'm going to show you with this section of hair. I think this will be the most practical, especially on a wedding day. The easiest way to know exactly where to place it, I'm going to use ears as a reference. I'm going to go from ear to ear. And that's the exact placement where you want it. So I'm going to go ahead and bobby pin it in place, and then I'll show you what our next step is. Now that we've secured this area with bobby pins, no need to worry, you're not going to see this area because we are going to cover it with this section of hair that's already curled. So I'm just twisting the hair and making sure that it covers the bobby pin. One of my most favorite things about the Cinderella hairstyle is these crystals that were in her hair. So today, we are using just these stones that we found at any craft store like Michael's or Joann's. And we are using eyelash glue, make sure that it's clear, not dark, to stick it onto the hair. I am placing the stones throughout her hair, using the eyelash adhesive. I used a Q-tip and put it on the back and just stuck it on. Don't use too much glue and don't use too little. This is our final and complete look for Cinderella's royal ball hairstyle.